This non-destructive testing equipment is a rebar cover meter and a rebar locator, this being the display unit of the equipment. The second part is the scanning probe. This is the cable to connect the display unit and the scanning probe. This cable is used to connect to the computer and download all the log data from the equipment to the computer to generate reports. This is an earpiece which is used in case the equipment is being used in a noisy environment. The adapter is used to charge the equipment. The primary objective of the equipment is to locate the orientation of the reinforcement bars, the concrete cover, and the estimated diameter. Its main objective is for building quality audits for quality control check to verify if the contractor has put in the required amount of reinforcement bars and to verify the spacing between the reinforcement bars and the concrete cover. It is a very portable and easy to use equipment in terms of its exceptional resolution and accuracy. Now we'll show you how the equipment is connected by using the cables. The cable is very easily connected to the display unit and the scanning probe. The compact probe is fitted with a replaceable bearing surface to protect the measurement face of the probe housing. We are also provided with a spare sole plate. It can be changed in case the one which is initially used has got some scratches.
Is the on button?
Now we press the red button to switch on the equipment. It has a press to calibrate button, which is a very important button to use, because wherever there is reinforcement, what we are talking about is a magnetic environment. So we must recalibrate the instrument before using it on any column. We even have a visual LCD display of what we find, measure. The red button is used to switch on the equipment, and the combination of the visual LCD display of the equipment and the audio sound that you can hear in the video enables us to very accurately find out the location of the rebar. Let us take an example of the rebar locator to be utilized on a column such as this, wherein we want to find out the location of the vertical bars along with the horizontal rings
and the covers.
Before we start the equipment, because it is a magnetic environment, we press the recalibration button, the button on the extreme left top of the equipment,
by keeping the probe
away from any metallic object
at least 1 meter.
The moment we do that, the equipment is ready to use. Now we start scanning the column. We first start finding out the location of the horizontal rings so that they do not come in between when we are locating the vertical bars. As we can see, the value 46. This is the cover of the rebar that is being shown on the display unit. The minimum value of the cover signifies that we are exactly on the top of the rebar. As the value is decreasing, we are coming nearer to the rebar.
This is the location.
This is the exact location of the horizontal ring behind the surface of the concrete.
Now we can mark.
We'll mark the position. Finding the next horizontal ring below this ring. And As we go below, we can see that the value of the cover is decreasing. Is the minimum cover value that we are getting. So this is the next horizontal ring, and we mark the location with a pencil. Now we'll start scanning for the vertical bars. As we move the probe, the value of the cover changes from 52 to 49. This is the location where we are getting the minimum cover, and this is the exact location of the rebar. Now to find out the estimated value of the diameter, we keep the probe exactly above the rebar, press the red button once and the center yellow button. The estimated value as shown by the display unit is 19.3, as we have a rebar of 20 inside this. Now to find out the next vertical rebar, we slide the scanner to the right side and press the button, red button, 3 times. As the value of the cover decreases, signifies that we are getting closer to the rebar. 45 or 46 is the minimum value attained, and we mark the position. Again, to find out the bar diameter, we press the red button and the central yellow button. And we get a value of 20.7. So this signifies that both the rebars are 20 mm diameter inside. What is being shown is the ease of use to do the building quality control on a building audit with this rebar locator and find out the exact location of the rebar and ensure that the reinforcement has been laid as per the map. Extremely easy to use instrument in quality control applications. Thank you. Just.